integuruma or squinage and ochigari, please choose ochigari. You know?
Yeah, yeah, ochigari, right? Like, because if you throw an osoto or, you know,
yeah,
that's like the worst kind of things. And that's why, yeah, for self-defense, like, oh, I got to tell you a funny story, but I'm not going to mention the name, okay? Because I don't want, I didn't get permission yet.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is a very high level judoka. We're talking like Olympic level.
Yeah.
You know, and of course has years and years of experience. And what happens is that there was a road rage incident.
Oh.
And so there was a road rage incident. So the judoka gets out of his car, and then the other gentleman gets out of the car. They start screaming at each other like in the middle of the street. And then, you know, the gentleman pushes the judoka, okay? And the judoka, of course, reacts and decks him, punches him. But, I mean, this judoka is strong, really strong. Like, he's, you know, like Olympic-level athlete. And on top of that, like, he's just one of those freakishly natural strength type, you know, like farmer strength kind of guys. Throws a punch, knocks him out. And the guy was essentially like out cold even before he hit the ground. But after he hit the ground, like half his face was completely smashed. And so the moral of the story is don't get into fights, of course. But the other moral of the story is this is an Olympic level judoka.
Yeah.
He didn't even, and his first instinct was to crack the guy's face.
Yeah.
It's the craziest thing. And then when he went to court for this, like, you know, there was witnesses, and the witnesses ended up saving him because nobody believed that he only hit him once.
Wow.
Everyone, because his face was so messed up. Like it, like when he got punched, right? He broke like his orbital bone, broke this, broke that. And then the guy landed and it broke some more stuff. So his half of face was broken essentially. So nobody believed that he punched him like with just one punch. They thought he just like punched him and then jumped on him and kept on punching and punching until the face got destroyed. So the witnesses there luckily saved him. But then they also asked him the question like, hey, how come you didn't use your judo?
Yeah.
And he said, well, I didn't have time to think. I mean, he pushed me. I thought like I was in danger. So I just punched him.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Also, like, that's the thing with judo. Other than the choice of throws, it's going to look, especially, like, again, don't do, like, really big pickups because they're going to look very, like, cringeworthy when you're watching them. So, for example, you know Shintaro Higashi?
Yeah, Shintaro. Mm-hmm.
He talked about self-defense and also for law enforcement, and he said, like, if you see a law enforcement video, it's like, when they like now it's very easy to just pull off your phone and if you see a law enforcement guy like just punching and swinging at the guy, like the whole world would go insane. But if you see him take him down gently and pinning him and then just negotiating with him and then arresting him, like that would go far more smoothly. But so again, that's why judo is a like a double-edged sword in a sense. Like you have these pickups that can look very badly and reflect very badly on someone, but you also have the choices to do very swift takedowns that you yourself know how to control them. And basically no one gets hurt, but at the same time, you know, you show, you know, who's in control of the situation. So like really clipping someone, like not the best, that's not gonna look very good on you, you know?
Mm. Yeah, exactly. You know, but the thing is like when you're in that situation, I mean, how often do you get into a situation like that? So when you do get into a situation like that, like your adrenaline is pumping, the anger, you know, so like you don't really have time to be thinking, I'm gonna move, circle, kill his sleeve, ochigari him, and then, you know, knee on belly and hold him down until like you can't think straight because you're angry. You know, when you're angry, you can't think. That's the problem.